बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। वेलकम बहावल सुमरो। टुडे आई वांट टू डिस्कस रूट वर्ड्स। एज यूजुअली बिफोर डिस्कसिंग द टॉपिक आई वांट टू आस्क सम क्वेश्चंस। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, व्हेनेवर यू रीड एनी काइंड ऑफ टेक्स्ट आर्टिकल और न्यूज़पेपर, डू यू फेस प्रॉब्लम्स विद द वोकैबुलरी? इफ येस, देन टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू solve that problem. Like when you read any text, any article, you come across certain new words. Those new words create hurdles, problems in order to understand the text. So if you know the basics of those words, like meaning of root words, as in my previous lecture I discussed affixes. In affixes, I discussed prefix and suffix, how they have fixed meaning. When we are going to attach those affixes and prefixes to the root words, how the meaning of those words is changed. So the basic is the root word. If we know meaning of the root word, we can understand the meaning of whole word when we are going to add affixes to that one. So the first one is TA. The word THEI, TA, means God or religion. This word is related to religion. This word is related to God. So the word is theist. Theist means one who believes in God. Who believes in one God. Theist. So a person who believes in one God, that is known as theist. If we add prefix to this word theist, a theist means not. So it will be a person who does not believe in one God. One who does not believe in God. In God or in any religion. Then next one is mono. Monotheist. Mono means one. Okay, so monotheist means person who believes in one God. Poly means many. Poly means many. So polytheist will be a person who believes in many gods. Pantheist. Pan means all around. So here pantheist means a person who believes in all gods. So the second word is logy. L-O-G-Y. Logy. Logy means study of something. So you will find so many words in which you will find word logy at the end. So here logy means study of something, like theology. Theo, as I told you, theo means religion. So study of religion. Then we have anthropology. Anthro means human being. So anthropology will be study of human being. Then we have word morphology. Morph, the word morph means structure. So it will become study of structures. So that is known as morphology, and this term is used in English linguistics. Then we have a third word, phobia. Phobia means fear or dislike. Similarly, you will find so many words where you will find phobia. So whenever you find word phobia, it means the meaning of that word will be fear or something like dislike. So zoophobia. Zoo means animal. So zoophobia means fear of animals. एंड्रोफोबिया. एंड्रो एक्चुअली एंड्रो मीन्स मेल और बॉय. सो अ पर्सन हु डज नॉट लाइक और हु डिसलाइक्स मेल और बॉयज इज नोन एज एंड्रोफोबिया. सिमिलरली गाइनोफोबिया. गाइनो मीन्स फीमेल और विमेन. सो गाइनोफोबिया. So it means a person who does not like female or women is known as gynophobia. Then we have pedophobia. Pedo means child. So pedophobia means a person who doesn't like children is known as is pedophobia. Then we have word demophobia. Demo means people, human beings. Demophobia means fear of public speaking. There are so many people, they are demophobia. They feel fear to talk before the people, before the audience. Anthrophobia. Anthro, as I told you, anthro means people or human beings. So a person who does not like human beings is known as anthrophobia. Then we have theophobia. Theo, I already told you, theo means religion. So phobia means fear of religion. So the fourth one is krasi. Krasi means government or system. There are so many words in which you will find krasi. Democracy, autocracy, plutocracy, krasi, krasi, krasi. So these are In other words, these are different types of governments. For example, the first one is democracy. Demo, as I told you, that demo means public, people. So democracy means government by people, or government for people, or government is run by people. Autocracy. Auto means dictatorship or kingship, autocracy. So this means government run by one dictator or one king. So that is known as autocracy. The next one is theocracy. Theo, as I told you, theo means religion. So theocracy means government run by religion, a religious person. We have plutocracy. Pluto means wealthy person. So government run by wealthy person is known as plutocracy. Then we have oligocracy. The word oligo means selected few people. So when some people are selected and they are running the government, we call that government as oligocracy. Then we have mobocracy. Mob means crowd. So government by the crowd. In other words, lawlessness. If many people are going to interfere in government affairs, definitely there will be lawlessness. Next word is gerontocracy. Gerontocracy, geronto means aged or experienced one. So cracy means government. So any government that is run by aged persons or that is run by experienced one, that is known as gerontocracy. Then meritocracy. Merit is a performance. So If there is a good performance, we call that one, there is a meritocracy. Means the things are on merit. Kleptocracy. Klepto means thief. So government run by thieves, that is known as kleptocracy. Then we have bureaucracy. Bureau actually means officials. Government run by officials is known as bureaucracy. And the last example is aristocracy. Aristo means nobility. So government run by noble persons is known as aristocracy. So the fifth word is somnia. Somnia means sleepiness. So this is somnia. Wherever you word, you find word somnia, that means it is talking about sleeping. So insomnia. In means not or lack of. Insomnia means lack of sleep. A person has insomnia, means he has lack of sleep. Similarly, we have somniferous. Ferus actually means things causing something. Okay, so somniferous are the things that cause sleep. For example, tablets, pills. Most of the time, people use somniferous at night in order to sleep well. So these are the somniferous are like the things or the tablets or pills that are used for the sleeping purpose. Okay, somnambulist. So ambu means walk. Somnambulist means a person who walks during sleep. Similarly, we have somniloquist. Loquist means talk. A person who talks during sleep is known as somniloquist. Next word is shush. Shush means do something. Most of the time you will find so many words where a shush root word is used. So for example, the word is loquacious. So loquacious, as I told you here, loquacious means talking. So loquacious means a person who talks a lot. He does not give chance others to speak. Just he speaks and speaks. Then we have voracious. Vore means eat. War means eat. Voracious means a person who eats a lot. Similarly, we have next one, avaricious. Avary means greed. Avaricious means a greedy person. Means he is avaricious, he is greedy. Pugnacious. Pug means fight. So pugnacious means a person who fights a lot. Okay, thank you very much. There is a huge list of words, root words that can be used. So I will share some other root words in coming lectures. Thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.